Melfab is proud to introduce this tandem tanker built for the Montague Fire Department in PEI. It is on a 2012 Freightliner M2112. It is powered by a Cummins 370 horsepower engine, has an Allison automatic transmission, has seating for three firefighters, has air conditioning, has a full back rear axle lockup. The front bumper is extended to house a 12,000-pound Warn winch with two storage compartments on the outer edges. The lighting package is a Federal LED light package. In the driver step, there is a connection for the battery Kussmaul conditioner, and there's also an auto eject for the airline connection. This unit has traction chains. The pump is a 625 PTO pump. The pump panel is covered by roll-up doors on both sides. The water capacity is 3,000 imperial gallons. At the top of the pump panel, there is a speaker for the communication radio, as well as a connection for the David Clark headset. There is a pump intake, pump discharge gauge, class 1 total pressure governor, the control for the 4-inch high vol, which has an electric valve. In the middle, there is a water level gauge, the discharge controls and gauges that are color-coded, two 2.5-inch discharges, a non-gated 6-inch inlet, a gated 2.5-inch inlet, a primer control with an indicator light to show when it is activated. The test plate from ULC is mounted at the bottom left portion. There are drains and a pump drain at the bottom of the pump panel. Underneath the pump house, there is a suction side relief valve, a heat pan, and a sump drain for the tank. The front left compartment is covered by an Amdor roll-up door, is lighted by LED compartment lights. It has an adjustable shelf. The chassis batteries are mounted in this compartment as well. The 12-volt electrical panel is recessed into the back wall. The rear fender well has a Zyco ditch light that is interlocked with the rear reverse gear of the transmission. It has dual LED flashers, and in the middle portion there is a storage compartment covered with a deck plate door that houses the wheel chocks. On the left side fender top there is a Zyco port tank rack. It has a painted aluminum cover over it. It has deck plate mounted on the body to protect the body. At the top corners, there are scene lights, and at the rear, there are beacons and rear floodlights. In the hose bed, which will be covered with a hose bed tarp, they are storage for two 4-inch suction hoses for the portable pump. There are two adjustable hose bed dividers. Underneath the hose bed, there's a traffic bar recessed into the body. There are a pair of scene lights and a 2.5-inch discharge. There is a step in the middle portion to allow easy access, easy reloading of hoses in the hose bed. There is a water level gauge beside the dump valve, which is a rotating dump valve manually controlled from the top of the dump valve. There is a gated 4-inch direct tank fill. Folding steps to gain access to the top of the hose bed. At the bottom portion, there's the switch for the Zyco port tank rack and a LED flasher and a turn signal, brake light, and rear backup module. In the storage over the right side fender top, there's a storage for two 6-inch suction hoses with a deck plate door. The step is a non-slip step. And underneath the body, there is a full-width mud flap. On the right side pump panel, there's an access door to gain access to the plumbing area. There's a 6-inch non-gated inlet and a 4-inch discharge with a 4-inch valve that is electrically controlled from the left side pump panel. The front compartment has a pull-out step that will contain a portable pump that is supplied with the unit and an adjustable shelf. The rear compartment has an adjustable shelf.